Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. New Madrid had another earthquake early this morning. It was at 8:08 a.m. Today is October 26, 2022, and it's Wednesday. Here's the earthquake station that I downloaded the data from, and we'll go to its location. It was only 3.8 miles in depth. All earthquakes are measured from sea level right there. But it wasn't a 2.7 like USGS said. And it wasn't just one earthquake. There was two. This is the one that they're reporting. And it actually was a magnitude 3.14. And probably about 15 seconds before the 3.14, there was this earthquake. I'll show you the seismic signature. Okay. And the first one comes in as a magnitude 1.68. Yeah, they're not reporting this one. Right there it is. Okay, let's close this out. They have another one that's marked in red. Oops, went off the line right there. Let's look at it. Yeah, tectonic in nature. Let's see what else we got here. We'll come up a little bit. Those are the only two marked in red. There is some little stuff here. Let's see, we got... Oh, actually, there's a lot of little stuff. I mean, look at that one. And that one. Let's bring it over. So if you've been thinking you've been feeling earthquakes, yep, there's been a few of them. Let's go over here. And what else do we got? Yeah, we got a few little ones down here afterwards. But they're not marked in red. Okay, we got one here. And another one there. Yeah, the New Madrid, you know the threat of a major earthquake that can happen there. All this white stuff, those are from ancient blowholes that occurred during that one major earthquake that they had in, 1811, 1812. And to the north, east of it, yeah, that's Realfoot Lake. That is an area that completely sunk, killed all the trees in the area, and dropped down. And so then up over here, this here is New Madrid. Yeah, 1811, 1812, that was that 8.5. So did you feel this recent earthquake this morning? Supposedly on USGS. Let's go there and look at what they say. Seven people reported to USGS that they did feel it. They gave it an intensity level of 4. Looks like all the reports probably came from this one area here. What do we got? 4 responses there. Where's the other ones from? Oop, let me go back. They're not showing where the other reports came from. Interesting. So, intensity level 4. Right here, which would mean a magnitude on the Richter scale of at least a 3, maybe a 3.5. Felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. At night, some would have been woken up. Well, 8 o'clock or so, they might have been getting up. Dishes, windows, doors were rattling. Automobiles rocking noticeably. So I want to go and talk about this here, and you can see here. Let me bring it up. This is the Richter scale magnitude. Oh, here it is. Here's the other reports. Let me bring this down. Louisville, Kentucky. How many people said they felt it there? One response there, intensity level 3, meaning it was felt indoors, noticeably, but not always recognized as an earthquake. Standing auto. Rocked slightly, vibration like a passing truck. So they're not posting all the felt reports. Here we have on the border there, we got Missouri, Tennessee, Arkansas over here. And again, this would be Kentucky. Yeah, I wonder why they, well, I'm not surprised. I don't know why they don't report them, you know, on the felt map. I wish they would put also what people said they experienced, but they don't do that either. So I know more than seven of you felt this earthquake. Please put those comments down below. What did it feel like? How long did it last? What direction did it feel like it moved? Was it a sudden jolt? Did you hear it before it occurred? Or was it a up and down waving motion? Yeah, let us know. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please like, share, and subscribe if you're not a subscriber. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.